Son, a non-corrupt, straightforward and service-minded police officer, Dr. Madhukar Shetty, IPS. He's from our own place. He's the son of the soil. He's basically from the erstwhile Dakshina Kannada district of Kundapur. He studied his initial studies in Mangalore, in St. Aloysius College. Later on, completed his degree in a very famous college of Bangalore, that National College. Thereafter, he pursued his education in our capital at Delhi, that too, in one of the prestigious institutions, Jawaharlal Nehru University. He completed his master's degree in political science. He is not an ordinary person. He is an illustrious person of a son of an illustrious person. His father is a well-known journalist of our district. Not only our district, is a very well-known journalist of state. He fought against corruption, against injustice with a pen. On the other hand, his son fought against corruption and illegal activities with a khaki. That is the only difference between the father and the son. And this Madhukar Shetty, he started his education in Aloysius College, thereafter switched on to National College and I completed master's degree at Delhi. Thereafter, he did his IPS, Indian Civil Service. He passed his Indian Civil Service in the year 1999 and appointed as a Karnataka cadre officer in Karnataka. So in the initial stage, he was working as an ACP in different places. Thereafter, he was given independent charge of Chamarajanagara and Chikmagalur district as superintendent of police. During his tenure as a superintendent of police in both the districts, he has done a wonderful job, especially in Chikmagalur, where an illegal occupation of unauthorized occupation of government land was withdrawn from the planters, that too very powerful planters, and he distributed, he along with another straightforward officer, Harsha Gupta, they formed a team. They were successful in getting the property which were encroached by the planters and distributed amongst about 35 Dalit families who are removed from the forest, forest land, and distributed amongst the Dalit family. That was his way of working. And thereafter, he was working as an SP at Lokayukta Karnataka, which was headed by Dr. Santosh Hegde. In Lokayukta, he did a commendable job, especially against the Bellari mines lobby, the mine barons. He was successful in arresting a minister who is involved in illegal mining activities. It is not an easy task at that time. The government was in power. In spite of that, he made a thorough investigation of illegal mine activities in Karnataka, especially in Bellary. So it was called, earlier it was called the Republic of Bellary. So he is the person, key person, along with Roop Kumar Datta, IPS. They dislodged these mines lobby at Bellary. He is successful in doing so. So he is a very straightforward, very sincere, very service-minded and very supportive to the poor people. So whenever you want to do something, think of the poorest in the land. Think whether they are benefited by it or not. It was stated by Gandhiji. In that principle, and according to the principle of his father, he was discharging his duty up to the entire satisfaction of the entire country. So that was Madhukar Shetty. You are all quite aware, as a mark of respect, in Chikmagalur, a village is named after Gupta and Shetty, Gupta and Madhukar Shetty. So that shows his capacity and his working capacity and his admiration for the poor. At the time of his death, he was working at Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel National Academy as an additional director. He died at the age of 47, very young age, very straightforward officer. When he died, he was about 47 years. Before his death, he was admitted to the Continental Hospital at Hyderabad, where he got admitted to get the treatment for the lung infection. He had got admitted for the lung infection. But the doctors there, they wrongly identified it as H1N1, and they gave a treatment for H1N1 for 2-3 days. Thereafter, they realized, that is the version of the doctors, they realized that it is not H1N1, and they again started resume their treatment for a lung infection, and at that time, he succumbed to that sickness. So, we lost a very eminent officer of Karnataka cadre. After his death, we are all suspicious about his death. Not only myself or my friends, the entire nation is suspicious. Even a cabinet minister of Karnataka state, he went to the extent of saying that there is some foul play in the death of Dr. Shetty, and it must be a thorough inquiry must be done. But they did not proceed with that one. A cloud of suspicion is looming large on the treatment given to him at that particular Continental Hospital. Suspicion has to be removed. To remove that suspicion, the state government has appointed a committee of eminent doctors and others. Eminent doctors include Dr. Devi Prasad Shetty and Dr. Prasad. These are the important doctors, very renowned doctors. They are in the committee. They are looking into the aspect of giving treatment to them. They are trying to cull out the nuggets of truth from what treatment has given to these persons. Dr. P. G. Girish.
Now, we are waiting for the report of the expert committee headed by Dr. Devi Prasad Shetty, our own man, our district. He's from our district. And not only that, there are other experts in the committee, Dr. P. G. Girish and others. So we are waiting for the report of the committee. If the committee report reflects there is negligence on the part of the treatment given to Dr. Shetty at Continental Hospital at Hyderabad, then the government should sue moto. They must refer the matter to CBI for investigation. If they do not refer the matter to CBI investigation, I am in connection with all the bar associations of Karnataka. I'll contact all of them and we'll agitate against them. This is our first demand. CBI inquiry must be done. Otherwise, definitely, statewide agitation of lawyers will be there. I am in touch with all the presidents of the Bar Association. That is one thing. And one of the minister has said, our Home Minister, then Home Minister, and now he is the same Home Minister, Mr. M.B. Patel has said that in his memory, a police training school of Mysore will be named after him. So far, no action has been taken. Immediately, they must proceed with that action. And secondly, what I want to tell is, he is a source of inspiration for all civil servants, civil servant service aspirants, and all executive aspirants, executive officers. So therefore, I am of the opinion, government should initiate a program, an academic program, to encourage the youngsters to go in the footsteps of Dr. Madhukar Shetty. If the government is not initiating, we are there to initiate an academic program in the name of Dr. Madhukar Shetty.